What the judge was trying to do in a slick way was trying to make me pay the mortgage, but just not to the lender, but to the court. So he ordered me to pay that, and he gave me 1 month to pay the $20,000. He set the next court date for December 5th. And December 5th, we went to court. I didn't pay anything. So he asked me why I haven't paid. I said because it was unfair. The mortgage loan was the product of fraud, and I didn't think that I should have to pay them a penny, because when I didn't have any evidence against them and I was begging them to modify my loan, they didn't want to do it. I had to take them to court. So now that they open a can of worms, I'm not going to let them go free. Nah, you're robbing people. And just because you get caught now, you want me to sweep the evidence under the rug and let you go? No, not so easy, no. So the judge asked me, said, okay, Mr. Muckle, How much money do you think you should have paid on this mortgage? I mean, you said that they committed fraud. How much money do you think you should have paid? I said, $1,200. He said, who told you? I said, well, my rent before this house was $1,500 a month, and they promised me that my mortgage is going to be lower than rent, so I should only pay $1,200. He said, okay, Mr. Muckle, pay $1,200. He said, I'm going to give you 3 months to pay $3,600 to the court registry. The money that you owe, forget about it. Just $3,600. And I'm going to give you 3 months. Every month, you're going to pay $1,200 into the court registry. After that, I'm going to modify the loan. I'm going to make a ruling on the loan. So basically what he did was he threw out all the money that I owed the bank. He threw it out. And he was going to start my new payments at $1,200 per month. I mean, this is great. I mean, wow, you know? But I thought about it. I knew in 3 months, my case would be end. I would win. I would get a low payment. I mean, my payment would be $1,200. And I would win a good victory. But what of others? I mean, the whole purpose of me filing this class action lawsuit was to help others who are suffering. So if I take this off of settlement, I'll be helping myself and no one else. So I did not pay the $1,200. I actually filed a motion asking to reconsider. My argument was that under the presumption of violation law, you know, the truth in lending laws, it was amended by Congress in 2004 in an amendment where they made it like if one lender is proven to have violated the law, right? Like giving homeowners loan knowing that the homeowners cannot repay that loan. Like if your lender gave you a mortgage knowing that you cannot repay the loan because it falls for your income, then under the law, if that lender had been found to have broke that law, then under the truth in lending laws, the judge is permitted to assume that this lender have a habit of giving loans to people who cannot afford a loan. So which means the court is empowered to block this lender from, the court is empowered to assume that all the loans in this lender's portfolio, all alone on this lender's books, and all alone that this lender have sold are unlawful loans, because from one loan, it can assume that he, all the loans are originated the same way. So my argument to the court was that I inspected other people's loan documents, and from my own loan document, where there's fraud, and it's proven that my lender falsified the income, that the judge can assume that all subprime loans are originated in the same way, and he should issue an injunction to block all foreclosures in the country. It's only fair, it's a law. I mean, why make laws if we're not going to follow them? And that's the problem in America today. We make laws and you don't follow them. You don't follow your own laws. And we call ourselves a nation of laws, but whose laws are we following? So, I mean, don't make a law, man, if you're not going to enforce it. And to boot, one of my lenders, Fremont Investment and Loan, the FDIC, listen to this very keenly, the FDIC did an investigation of Fremont Investment and Loan, and they discovered that Fremont Investment and Loan had a habit of giving homeowners loans that they couldn't afford. I mean, they had the evidence. And so In April 2007, the Federal Deposit Insurance Corporation, the FDIC, gave Fremont a cease and desist order. In that order, it told Fremont Investment and Loan to stop, to cease and desist giving people loans knowing that they cannot repay them. It also ordered that Fremont Investment and Loan correct all its mistakes. And the order also empowered any federal or state agency, which means the FBI, the U.S. Marshal, the police, the courts, anybody who have the authority to enforce this order against Fremont Investment and Loan, the associates, the affiliates, and anyone they do business with, including the people who they sold their loans to. So what that means that when your marshal or your local sheriff brings to you an eviction notice, he is violating your law, your rights, because his duty under the FDIC order is to block Fremont Investment and Loan and all the affiliates and associates and everyone they do business with from kicking you out of your own house. Let me repeat that. Under the FDIC rule, the order to Fremont, to the courts, to the marshals, to the police and the sheriffs, is that a Fremont Investment and Loan or any of their holders was to send you an eviction notice saying you need to get out of your house, you need to pay your mortgage. Listen up keenly. Listen up, let me back up. Let me say this, right? If you have an adjustable rate mortgage loan where the interest goes up, your loan is an unlawful high cost mortgage loan. That means that you are not required under the law to pay the bank one penny unless they modify your loan to your benefit. Under the truth in lending laws, if your loan is in violation, your lender doesn't have the authority to foreclose on your property and sell it. So which means when your local sheriff brings you an eviction notice, he's violating the FDIC order because he's enforcing an unlawful home mortgage loan terms. He's enforcing the terms of an illegal loan because the terms say that the lender could foreclose. It's unlawful, it's illegal. Okay, I did the research. Anyway, backtracking a little bit. After Fremont Investment and Loans got the order from the FDIC, they got slick because the order was that they are supposed to correct the violations, and that correction of violation means that that every loan that Fremont Investment and Loans originated that have features where the income was falsified, then Fremont Investment and Loan must modify those loans to terms acceptable to the homeowner. But Fremont got slick. Instead of modifying your loans, they sold. Well, actually, they said sold, but it's really transferred. They deferred payments of your loans to another company like Wells Fargo. You know, those holders of mortgage notes. Wells Fargo is included. So Fremont transferred those loans to other companies in an attempt to escape liability and have to fix your loan. Now, the thing about the FDIC order, it also goes out to all of Fremont's holders. That means whoever Fremont transferred their loans to, they are under the FDIC's order. And they're not telling you that. They are still enforcing an unlawful mortgage loans. And like I said, every single subprime loan that have an adjustable rate interest is unlawful because the fees that you're paying, you're robbed. I mean, they didn't tell you why you're paying high interest. But I know why, and I'm gonna prove it to you.